What's up, everybody? Welcome to day 500 and something. Making Songbringer. What am I working on today? The overworld generator. Check this out. Little problem with the old world generator a little bit. Yo, Pedro, what's up, man? So what happened was it would sometimes generate these long divides where a whole half of the freaking world was just, you know, you couldn't get past it. You had to go all the way around. If you want to get to this point over here, you'd have to walk all the way around this giant wall of red right here. So this kind of a issue in, I don't know, I guess maybe like 30% of worlds are kind of like that. It's really prevalent. I played a lot of worlds where this would happen. So I need to work on the overworld generator and improve it so that it places the gates at the right position, so that it creates a world where there's plenty of gates as it goes from one section to another. It puts gates and allows you to pass through these kind of like walls here. So that's the goal for today's stream. Yeah, long time no see, man. How have you been? I'm good. Life's great. The game's coming amazing. Really enjoying it. I'm really enjoying this. These last days making Songbringer. You know, there's a lot of, I mean, I'm definitely in the end of the project here. So getting there. All right. So I want to go to World Xanadu. And let's turn on the overworld view. Whoa, are you changing jobs? Nice, man. What's this new job you got? Here's Xanadu. Okay, and then Xanadu is also one of these problem worlds. This is the world that I use to debug on a daily basis. Let me show you the problem with Xanadu. Xanadu has this problem where, let's highlight, yeah, it looks about right size. Here's one gate. It goes from, so the gates usually happen, actually they do, they all happen as you're going from one section to another. So you can see there's this section here. This is the sandy section, which happens to be the home section for this world. And then there's this green section over here. And then there's another little bit of sand here. And there's like some dark forest here. So it put a gate here. It put a gate here. And then it put a gate here. So as you can see, there's a lot of opportunity for gate placement in other areas. It would be so much better if these were more distributed. Two of the gates are right next to each other, and then there's this one other gate over here, but this is not at all spread out. They should just, the gates should spread themselves out so that you don't get the situation like this, or wait, no, like this. Where you have a whole section that's just like closed off. Whoa, 3D engine? Nice, man. Oh, sweet, Pedro. Congrats, dude. Congratulations. What are you doing to celebrate? Okay, so my plan is here's the overworld generator, when it's choosing the places for the gates, it goes and it lists all the possible gate positions. Whoa. Yeah, man, that is. That sounds like a hefty pipeline for sure. So it lists all the possible gates where, like, here's a possible gate, here's a possible gate, here's a possible gate, there's a possible gate. There's possible gates wherever a section touches another section, and there's a path right there. So there's like possible gates all over the freaking place. So the way to actually do it so it's distributed is to look at the angles. So I'm going to actually measure the angle for each one of these gate positions. Measure the angle from the gate, the potential gate to the home. So there, that'll have an angle like that. This one will have an angle like that. This one will have an angle like that and like that. And then, as all these gates have their angles computed, then sort all of the gates by their angle and then choose a distributed list. If you want four different gates, for example, from the home section into the other sections, then you choose the most distributed four angles you've got. So if you've got four angles and you've got like 16 possible positions, and you choose every fourth angle. Simple algorithm. Oh, dang, man. You wanted to get some days off, but dang, you're getting straight into it, huh? Oh, sweet. You're gonna get a fancy restaurant? Yeah, right on. Sweet, dude. What are you gonna eat? What are you gonna drink? So that's how the algorithm will work. The that's the easy part. The easy part is improving the algorithm. The difficult part is how it's going to change every single world in all of Songbringer to do this. Because the way the maze generator works for the overworld is it actually generates a maze that's smart about where it goes and places its gates. So it has to know all its gate locations before it even ever does the maze. And then the maze can cross into different sections at the gate points. See how this point right here, this point here, this dark green one, surrounded by sand. See how the maze goes like this, and then it dead ends here, and then goes back out. Because it can't cross into this section because it's not a gate location. Same here. And there, okay, so there is a gate right here. Yeah. That's where the fourth gate is. So there's a gate there, 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 and there. So this because the maze generator has to use those gates, if you're going to change the gate locations, it's going to completely change the maze that gets generated for probably at least 80 to 90% of all worlds for Songbringer. So that's the trick. I either have to just let go of it at this point and be like, you know what? There's no way to actually get the worlds to be better without changing all the worlds. Since this is still the beta version, that's okay. I can change the worlds. I think this is a move that's pretty important. I can't have worlds like this. This sucks. You play a world like this called, this one's called Cyan. I think it's named after Dragon Ball Z, dude. But anyways, this whole blocked off wall, giant wall here, this can't happen. So we gotta make this improvement to the overworld generator. It just means that basically people that are playing Songbringer right now, they're in the middle of a world they're playing in the beta version. All they gotta do is just disable automatic updates so for a while until they finish whatever world they're playing. So basically these worlds will just improve. And if they ever do play, if you're one of these people and you're paying attention to the Songbringer project, whatever, if you're in the middle of a world right now and the world does change on you, let's say you didn't disable automatic updates, it wouldn't matter. All your items would still be there. Pretty much all the dungeons will be exactly the same too. It's just that the overworld may have shifted its position of stuff. You'll still keep all your stuff that you've collected in that world. It's just that the positions will have changed. Sushi, right on. What's up, Assassin? This is already done. This is an overworld generator for a Zelda-like game called Songbringer. This is like a Zelda-like overworld. Yeah, I ditched it. I couldn't get it fixed. Overlay chat window just, yeah, took a dump. Seriously, I upgraded Game Show at one point and then it just stopped working. It got all squished. You remember that, right? When it was all squished? Okay, so I'm gonna go to the maze generator. Okay, and see, here's where it actually does the gate sections. So it finds all, it finds, here's where it finds all the possible edges. And then turns, and all those edges become gates, and then it removes corners, singles, traverse. So this is where we have to do the, where I have to do it. Oh, you know what? I know, right? Maze infinite? What do you mean? What you mean by that? You mean is this like an infinite world? No, it's not an infinite. Let me show you the game real quick before I start on the code. Oh, turn off the overworld generator here. So this is one of the dungeons. This is not the overworld that I was just talking about there, but the dungeons work with a totally different style generator. So there's a dungeon generator and there's an overworld generator, and they have different logic. But let me take you back to the overworld and I'll show you what that looks like. So here we are. This is back at the overworld. I was just talking about this world. I was just like highlighting all the drawing and stuff of this world. That's where I'm at right now. So I'll go into God mode and you can see that it's a big world. And it generates, like I was saying, it generates a maze that's different than the dungeons. The dungeons work in a totally different style. But anyways, that's kind of a little quick overview of Songbringer. So, like I said, what I'm working on today is fixing up the overworld generator so that it generates better gate positions. So, we need to get the angle for all the possible edges. And then sort them. That's really all that needs to be done. Okay, so there's a choose gates function. I'm thinking I'll probably add a function in here called like filter gates, or no, like I guess it's just choose gates. It'll sort them. Yeah, I guess I just write where choose gates is, or maybe there's a choose gates and then there's a choose gates. There's two versions of this choose gates function. That might be one way to do it. Okay, so choose gates passes in a const vector of possible ones. So it's not modifying the possible gates. Remove traverse, remove singles, remove corners. So I'm just going to review the way the choose gates function already works. I think what it does is it actually does things at random. Oh, okay, right. First of all, it favors choosing a gate into a section that has not been tried yet. And also works randomly. So it chooses at random one of the gate positions. Into a new section. So in this example here, like if it had already chosen a gate into the dark green section, then it would have to choose the next gate into the light green section over here, or this, brown section here. So I think I want to write a totally different function that sh that totally that favors the angles. I'm trying to decide whether I'll keep this bit right here, where it's filtering in, where it's checking out all the sections that it could possibly link into. Because I think if you're doing it by angle, and you've got a choice of basically like up to 180 degrees angles or whatever, you're gonna be doing like and you have like four different gates that you want to place. Then you're probably going to be choosing something at, one gate goes about, if you do it by angles, one gate's going to go about there. One gate's going to go about here. One gate's going to go about there. And then another gate's going to go about there. So it's going to like, most likely it's going to automatically link into all the sections. And then as long as I keep the, so if I just do the first section, your home section does this new algorithm. The other sections continue to work the way they did. So they just choose gates at random, but as long as they're into a new section. Or I could just improve this algorithm so that it. It like always sorts it. It always sorts the possible gates by their angle and always does the same algorithm. That would mean that every single section would work this way, not just the home section. So that would mean that as the green, like for the green section, would have to do, say, like three more. Let's say the green set. Wait, how many gates does the green section have? It looks like the green. Okay, so the green section got three gates. One there, one there, one there. Let's confirm that. From the light jungle, two, two, three. Okay, oh yeah. This has three gates. Oh, from the light jungle only has two? What? Really? What? Gate section? Oh, no, wait, that's the gate types. Oh, wait, no, okay, so there's four different gates because there's four, okay. From the sand, you only have two gates. What's up, Carrot? How's it going? All right. So the green section here, this has two gates that go out of it. So if you chose the most distributed angles, and you're choosing the two gates, then you would probably choose about there and there. Yeah, because these have to go from the sand into either the dark or the mountains. So it's putting two more gates into the dark or the mountains. So it's only going to go into there or there. And so it would have a distributed list of angles for those. So it would be like one, two, these would be some angles, these would be some angles. And then it would choose the most distributed of those two angles. So it probably would work. Probably wouldn't even need to do this whole guaranteeing it has to gate into those other sections. Okay, what I'll do is I'll start with an algorithm that I'll start with a new algorithm, basically, a brand new one that works with the same format. Whoa, nice. Good for him, man. Jonathan Blow's been streaming daily. Good for him. You were learning encryption languages? Wow. Does anyone code review your stuff? No. What's up? Should be reading. What should you be reading? Okay, so let's make a new version of this. We'll just call it choose gates two for now. Right, so we'll do some logic at the end of this function too, like if it fails. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is sort all of the gates by their angle to the home position. So, for example, when we're starting with this yellow section, this document's getting crazy. Let's start over with that. Okay, so starting with this is the these are all the gates that it's going to have potential. Like it's going to have a gate there, 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 there. All along here, 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 here. Whoops. And it goes like that, right? So every single one of these edges here is considered a possible gate location. And so all of them, I need to measure the angles back to the home screen. All right, so possible is a list of edges. Each edge, I haven't worked on this code in a minute, so let me remember what an edge was. Oh yeah, it has its x, its y, its x squared, y squared, or y times x times two, x y times two, its quadrant, and its direction. I guess we could give each one an angle too, and then sort by angle. Do that. Angle equals zero. Give it an operator less than so we can use sort. So if my angle is less than your angle, I think that's how we'll need to sort it, but I'll confirm that later. And this should be a const. Why is this not const? It still compile? Yeah, all right, good. Okay, so I'll set a breakpoint there when I actually go to finally debug this code once it's all written. Maze Gen, Mage, Maze Gen, take me to the Maze Gen. Where's that edge thing again? Is it a struct? It's probably a struct. Oh, it's not here. Where is this? Maze.cpp. There we go. All right, so I'll set a breakpoint here so I can check that. Make sure that's working. All right, so good job. Choose gates. All right, so now we need to go in, and once we've listed all the gates, we can just, now that we've added an angle variable to the edge, we can, when we actually list all the gates, that's where we can measure the angle edges. So find edges squared. Can I go find a word? Oh, I wish you could find a word. Huh. I wish I knew how to do that in Vim. There's probably a simple way to do that in Vim where you find the word underneath your cursor. You reverse it. Nice. What does that say? Stream. I love your stream. Never give up. Nice, man. That's an important part of encryption. Reversing things. All right, so when we find all the edges, easy way to do this would be to make it so that maze makes you give it an angle. Nice, you're learning Morse code? I always get tripped out into like TV shows and movies where people can just read Morse code really fast. I'm like, how do they do that? Can they really do that? Can spies really speak like 10 languages and understand Morse code and be really great fighters? Whoa, whoa. All right, so this is going to be one location where we're going to need to pass or push an angle. So, we need to get an angle of, I think it's ATAN2. ATAN2 or something like that. Is this the only one? Only error? There are two edges. 640.74 and 1019. This is 674. Where's 1019? I forget how to go to a line in Vim. That's probably a good point. Yeah, I like that. I mean, that is a good point. I gotta remember how to do this. Yo, you just type the number and then shift G? Is that right? Oh yeah, that's all you do. All right, so this is edges, pushback. Which one is this? Connect any unconnected. Okay, so we don't really need to push back the angle for these edges. We'll just give that 0.0. And then the other location was 674, shift G. There we go. Okay, so we need to pass in an angle for this point, which is just xy. Where do I get an angle from in my own code base? See, Coco's 2DX does it this way. It normalizes and then uses a tan 2f. What's up, Salad? It's going good, man. How about you? Yeah, I know it was a tan 2, but do you have to normalize the angles? Not bad, right on. What you doing today? Oh, what's it say? What's it say? What's up, Ease? I'm good, man. Really good. I'm working on improving the overworld generator today. Okay, let's just use this. Oh, right on. Into latex? Crazy. Latex. I'm pretty sure Vec2 has a static get angle. Or does it not? It doesn't. Oh, you could get the one position and then, all right. Okay, so we'll get a Vec2 to the home point and then just push back that get angle to a new Vec2. So, all right, so we got Vec2. This is the home position. So home pause is this is home. It's not home pause. Oh, it's start X. Think. Yeah, start X, start Y, size X, size Y. Okay, so we got a vector, the location of the home point, and then our angle is going to become home pause dot get angle to vec2 of this point. All right, now I'm going to set a breakpoint. After it finds edges squared, well, let's kill that. We don't need to index everything. Find edges squared. Oops, forgot us. Parentheses, more two. How many parentheses do you want, man? They don't recognize it as a word? What? So after we call find edges squared, we can set a breakpoint and check out all the angles. So we're running world Xanadu still, right? I think it's Xanadu. Big motivation issues. Oh, you're moving house and you're running exams? Yeah, that's stressful, man. Sounds like you just got, you got stuff you got to get done before you can do your... All right, Pedro. Check you later, man. Congratulations on the job. Okay, so let's run that with debugger attached. And we'll check things out. I'm going to get a drink of water, though. Oh, I know, right? Ah, well, good luck, man. All right, did we hit this breakpoint? What happened here? Why is it breaking in maze? Hold on, maybe that's... All right, okay. So we called find edges squared. We got all the edges. Metrius, thank you for auto hosting. All right, now we need to look at all the angles and the XY positions of stuff and just see if the angles, the math seems to be working out. Angle zero, angle zero. What? Those, I guess those could be. Oh, yeah, wait, here we got an angle, 0.07. But 8.0, 8.0. I guess they could be angle zero. 8.0, 14.0, those are angle zero. No, there's no official release date for Songbringer yet. Okay, let's look at the world. All right, so we're looking at position. What is this again? Let's look at the first edge it finds. It's at 8.0. Well, I guess it should, oh, you should do the angle from the X2, Y2. I'll do that in a second. So 8.0, but it's actually 17.1. So it's that edge we're talking about right here. And its angle to the home screen, or to the home, yeah, to this home right here, I guess the angle would be zero. But not if we did the Y2 being one, which will help a little. Let's do that. Let's turn off, wait, let's keep that on. Home pause, get angle to X2, Y2, wait, did we just, let's just call that, wait, Wait. The edge actually computes the x2, y2. Okay, which means I could just send it, give it, yeah. Okay, I'll pass when I create an edge. I'll pass in instead of angle. I'll have this compute the angle. It's kind of a more pro way to do it, I guess. So we call get x2, y2, and then angle equals back to start x, start y, give the angle to x2, y2. What's that say? Oh, ASCII, right on. Oh, it's a link to my channel, right on. Cool, carrot. That's a neat way to encode it. It's all ASCII. Then back in here, when we create, we don't need to store home pause or anything. All we gotta do is pass it the start X, start Y. And there's one other location where it does this. Make sure that works. Whips. Oh. Extraneous. How many of these we got? One, two, one, two. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Batch files. What? Why do you miss batch files? What are VBS files again? Oh, Visual Basic. Right? I used to code in Visual Basic. It was one of the first languages I learned. Quick Basic. Later on, Visual Basic. Basic, man. Basic. Whoa. Great. Now it's working again. Okay, so this time the angles should be a little bit better quality because it's based on the x2, y2, which includes the quadrant of the current gate. All right, so there. We're looking at the same thing, Xanadu, and we're looking at this first gate right here of 8, 0. Yep, this time it has an angle of 0.05. Nice, right on. Logs into Chrome. But 8, 0 itself all is an angle of 0. That's fine. As long as there's a little bit of difference between the angles. Let's see what else we got. 2-1, an angle of 0.64. 2-1. So that's 1-2-1. So we're probably talking about that gate right there. The angle it gave is 0.64. If this is 0, this is 0.64. Does that make sense? It would 0.6, is that right? Think about it. This is 2 pi. 2 pi would go all the way around the circle, and this is almost pi. So this should be almost 1.57. Shouldn't it? This can't be right. Because this one's also 2-1. And its angle is 0.54. Eight one, 8-1. 14-1. 14-1. I think I've had this problem before with using Cocos 2DX's angle function. Have I? HD, what's up, man? Yeah, sorry, man. I've been sick this week. I haven't streamed that much. Still sick. Waking up, hawking loogies and stuff. It's no fun. Right on. Templar code. What's the Templar code? You mean template code? Okay, so what I'm doing here is I'm inspecting some angles. Oh, yeah, it's no worries. It's not that bad. You gotta get sick every once in a while. Down with the sickness. Templar, what's that? What's Templar code? Yeah, I am. I'm feeling a lot better than I was a couple days ago. How about you, man? What you doing? How are you? What's going on? Okay, finally we have an angle to. Oh! It does make sense now. Or, but it. But it. Okay, I'm just gonna ditch their algorithm for a minute. I think the angle is a little simpler. Think the angle is just angle equals a tan 2f of, wait, what is it again? How does their algorithm work? This is Templar? What? Oh, you all right? Yeah, what's up? What are you doing, man? Are you doing today? Oh, it's just a tan 2f y x. There we go. That's all I want. I think that other function is the one that I'm kind of wary of. All right, so y is, so we're gonna take y2 minus start x, start y squared, and then the X part is x2 minus, I think this will work if we're not square, if we're working with squares and all that, or with a non-normalized angle. That's what my programmer instinct says to do this. Let's try it. Y2, Y, X2, X. Got edgy. If you get amazing, you get Let's try that. Teak, what's up, man? How's it going? Everybody's here. Nice, you been playing? How do you get past the crab pincher on the boss floor? You mean when you're fighting the boss? Or are you talking about the little green guys? The little green ones, or the guys on the boss that are more brown and bigger? It's a party! Everybody's here! You tried everything? No, not the guys on the boss. So you're talking about the little green guys? I'll fight him and show you that real quick. Let me just stop this. I think it's actually dungeon 5 for me too. The solids that block your path. Okay. All right, I got you. I'm gonna give you a hint. I'm gonna give you a hint about this, all right? What item did you just get? In that dungeon, you will have gotten an item. If you didn't get an item yet, it's like one of those items where you go downstairs and you get like a special item. What item did you get? There. Turn on that breakpoint. Okay, and if you're just tuning into the stream, I'm just going to recap real quick. What I'm working on is an improvement to the overworld generator, which will choose smarter gate locations. You can see Xanadu has a pretty dumb gate locations. It's got one there, one there. And then two right here and here, which are not very distributed. At least these two should be farther apart, right? It would be nice if maybe you had one here, and you had one there, and you had one maybe like there, and then one like around here. That would be really nice and distributed when created a nice world. The problem is you get worlds like this sometimes where you have these long divides where you can't get past these walls. That's what I'm working on. I'm improving the world generator so it doesn't create these long walls anymore on the, but this is the overworld only. The dungeons work different. Oh, whoa. Oh, all right. Cool, man. That's interesting. Yeah, you've probably run into this playing Songbringer because it's in a lot of worlds. Because the current algorithm is really dumb. It goes and it lists all the possible gates and then it chooses one at random. So dumb. So what I'm doing now is I'm sorting all the gates by their angle to the home screen and then choosing a nicely distributed list. Oh, you didn't get the item yet? You gotta get the item. You want me to show you? I can show you on mine. It's probably the same item. I think it is the same item, because that dungeon always has the same item. Yes, exactly, Teeks. I'm glad you're on this stream. I'm really glad you're on this stream, because this is I'm finally having to change the worlds, right? It's been a long time. You've been playing Songbringer for like 6 months or whatever with it. I've never touched the overworld generator in the last 6 months. But now it's time to make version 12 because this is important, you know. All right, okay, let me show you. Let me show you. I think it's dungeon 5 in this world. Yeah, cool. This is dungeon 5. So, yeah, you need to find the item. I'm just cheating here, sorry. I know it makes everything easy when you cheat. Wait, so what world is this? 0051? Hold on. Nice, man. Cool. I think you're really gonna love this next update too. It's really improving things. By the way, okay, while you guys are on the stream, you're watching this and stuff. Anybody that's got Songbringer already, you already have the beta version. This is so since I'm working on the overworld and stuff, and some improvements to the dungeons. If you're currently playing a world, like Ichthys, for example, if you're playing a world and you don't want it to change, you probably should disable automatic updates for Songbringer for now, until you're ready to play the newest version. Because the newest version that comes out like this next weekend will be, will have some changes that may change your world a bit. Your items will always stay intact. If you're playing a world, it will never lose what items you obtain, but the positions of items and the positions of dungeons and things like that can change. So there you go. That's the item, and it's got this. It's hinting. This whole area right here is hinting at what you need to do. Whoa, Teeks, right on! You're gonna start a new world. Cool. You got this? Ichni, did that make sense? Did that help? Is that triggering it? Is that actually what you were asking about? Yeah, Lena's totally. No, I've been inspired by Lena's the whole time. I actually read all his articles about how to do proc gen dungeons, and Songbringer's dungeon generator is based off of his articles. So I started with his articles, wrote some code kind of similar, but then since then the dungeon generator has changed a lot since. Man, that was like a whole 2 years ago. Yeah, I remember. I own Lena's Inception. I've played Lena's Inception. I've read his articles. He's a great, cool guy too. We're following each other on Twitter. Yeah. Yep. So I'm gonna just save and quit. I'm just gonna exit. Right, so back to this breakpoint. I'm gonna see if these angles are better now. Oh, you have that. Oh. Well. Oh. So, did that hint at something? Do you know what to do? Hope that's a big enough hint. I don't want to spoil anything for you. Okay, so this time 8-0 has an angle of 0.3. Fourteen 0.07. What's 2-1? It says an angle of 2.8. 2.8. Oh. Nice. Right on. I don't know if I got this right this time either. The angles, this one's 2.8. Which way does it measure them though? I thought it would be 1.5. The angle to would be a 1 pi. Oh, right. Oh, that is right. Hold on. So this is 0. This is half a pi, so this is 1.57. And this would be 3.14. Oh, now, yeah. All right. So maybe this is working. Because eight, let's see, eight, where's two? Here's 2-1, which is actually 5-3. This one's 4-3. So the 4-3-1 should have a higher angle. 2.85, 2.81. It is. Yay, it's starting to make sense, and I think this is the right math. So I measured the angle correctly. All right, so the next thing it needs to do is actually measure its angles from the center point of the this section. So the center point of this section would be about right here. It's like a sort of like a pivot point. The center point of this green section would be like right here. Oh, but I wonder if this, like, I should just do it from the center of the whole world because these ones, there's two. This one's divided. It has two sections for the dark green section. And so I guess I could write some smart stuff that would be like, oh, it's in the middle of this section over here. Because they're all touching. But that's complicated. So what if I did just do the center point of the whole world halfway on the Y and the X? So this would become, yeah, that would work, I guess. So this would be like this, these would be the new angles. And then this section would have angles kind of like this. Wait, no. This section would have angles like this. And this dark green section would have angles like that. I guess that would work. Yeah, all right, let's just do the let's start with the bigger picture here. The bigger picture is I need to sort all these edges by their angle and then choose a well-distributed list. So if we have 4 points to choose, it'll choose like every fourth or whatever, every so many so that it chooses a nice distribution. Okay, so this is choose gates two. Actually, we should sort the edges first. Forget how to do a sort algorithm. I think it's like a sort or something. Oh, it's just a sort algorithm. Possible to begin, possible end. Cool, man. All right, I'm gonna set a breakpoint right before they're sorted. Here it is before they're sorted, starting with like 8-0, which is actually pretty close, but then it jumps into 2-1, which is way on the other side of the angles. So, it's sorted them now. Let's see what they look like now. So, we're still starting with 8-0. No, it didn't work. Angle. Oh, am I looking at edges? I want to look at possible gates, not edges. Duh. Okay, so possible gates, 8-0, 14-0, yep, 14-1, yeah, it sorted them, right on, 14, so the last ones should be like the 2-1, yeah, 2.8, 2.81, 2.79, yeah, we got a sorted list of gates. Yeah, exactly. No matter what, what I was saying there was no matter what, even if you didn't turn off, yeah, isn't it called keep build updated? Even if you didn't turn that off, you would still keep your items. All I'm saying is the location of items that you haven't gotten yet, those will have changed, so you wouldn't even know that it will change. All I'm saying is the location of items will change. The location, and it really is a location of new items and old items you've already gotten. You probably don't care about the items you've already gotten, but the new items, I don't know. The overworld will change too. So the paths that you walk along the overworld will have changed, and your map may change. So yeah, if you want to do this, you want to go updates, and then instead of having it always keep this game up to date, No, wait, it's none of those. You want cloud sync? It's not. How do you disable updates again? I thought there was a way to do this. Yeah, you probably, yeah, if you want to keep everything exactly the same. Oh, you know how? All right. But how do I do it? Tell me how to get there. Keep build updated? Where was that at? You have to right click on it or something? Is this just the Mac version? Does the Mac version not have it? I swear on my Windows, it had that. You could just disable updates. It's in local files? I think it might be my Mac version. Was I? That's what I thought. It didn't have the option though to disable. I'm in updates, automatic updates. You would think there'd be something like disable updates for this game. But it doesn't have that. Every single one of these options will update the game. Oh, I guess you could do this. Set it to update when you launch and only launch in offline. That kind of sucks though. I thought you could disable automatic updates. I swear there's an option. Oh, they renamed it. They renamed Do Not Automatically Update to Only Update When You Launch. So you have to. Yeah, I just went to local files, same thing. You mean you can browse your file? I guess you could backup. Can you backup game files? What does that do? I guess I can back up to the desktop. Let's see what this does. Oh, can you? Oh, I can disable automatic updates? Yeah, I don't want to do that though. I want everybody to have updates by default. I just want to warn people that are playing it right now. If they do want to keep the exact layout of the world they're playing, just make a backup. Then you know what? You don't even need Steam to back it up for you. All you would have to do is just go and copy the freaking folder. That's all you need to do. Just copy the folder as it is with the assets and your game saves file and everything, and the executable file you have and everything. Or use this backup feature, would that work? Disk one. Oh, that's, no, you don't want to use this backup thing from Steam. This is not what you want. Okay, whatever. So yeah, I guess the only way to really make sure you got it backed up is just to go to your local files, browse your local files, and just go back to the one folder above the local files for Songbringer and then just like copy the whole Songbringer folder somewhere. And then run Songbringer manually from that folder. So all you, what, let's see, I'll show you. So if I copy it to the desktop now, it's like 300 megs, it's not too big. And then you just go to whatever platform you want to run. Like if you're on Windows, just go to the songbringer.exe and just run it straight from there. And that will make sure that you got a copy of that game with the world exactly as it was for a while. Yeah, I could do that. It's a good point, Teak. I could do that, but I kind of am leaning against it because I like... This is... People already know that Songbringer is the beta version. You know, I kind of don't want to do a beta version while it's already the beta version. I think it would confuse things for me, at least as a developer. It'd be harder for me to be like, all right, I'm pushing out an update, but I'm only doing the beta, even though it already is a beta. Yeah, good, good. Yeah, the final build for sure will be the final build, and the worlds will never change at that point. Yeah. I guess so, huh? Huh. Huh. Let me close this. All right, so we've got all the angles, all the edges sorted by angles. So now we can use a smarter choose gates. So either I recode this game's called Songbringer. Either I read or write this function. Oh, I do know what. Okay, so I want like four gates or whatever. Let's set a breakpoint here. Step through this algorithm for the first time it does this. What's the genre? It's an action RPG. All right, it's getting its possible section. Let's continue this. Thanks, Teague. Right, what do we got for possible? Possible is the list of gates. These should be all sorted. Yep. Yeah, so we know that we're choosing gate number like zero of what's n? Can you play? Yes, there's two ways to play. Well, there's one way to play actually for now. It's just you gotta pre-order the game or wait till it comes out. I guess there are two ways. So if you want to play the beta version currently, you can go to songbringer.com/pre-order, and you have to pre-order the $32 version if you want to play the beta. If you order the $16 version, you'll get a copy of the game, a Steam key via a Humble Bundle when the game is released. Cool, man. And yeah, and if you order the beta version, you also get the game when it comes out, of course. Your beta key will always work. Even so, your beta key will work during the beta, and your beta key will also work during the final version. You just get the game forever. So yeah, we're placing four gates, and this is the zero gate, so we're like 25% of the way, or 0% of the way. What we want to do 25%, 50%, 75%, 100, no, not 100%. If we have four gates that we want to place, we want to do, we want to be a little offset, so it's more like with that, if there's four gates to place, there's actually five different deltas from this gate to that gate, this gate to that gate. So, right? So we would choose 20% along the way. Let's get rid of all these lines again. This is like getting dirty, 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 dirty. I just need to do a new layer. Okay, so if we have, we're gonna place gates along the this section, right? This section's edges. So we've got a gate there, there. These are possible gate locations. What this next step is about is if we've got like 20 different gate locations or whatever, and we've got four different gates we want to place, that's actually five different deltas or whatever. So basically, we want to choose 20% along the way, 40% along the way, 60% along the way, and 80% along the way to generate the most distributed list of gates. Cheers, carrot. So that's just going to be float percent equals. One plus I over one plus N. So we've got four different gates. That means this denominator is five, and it goes one. And we get up to zero. Wait, this might be wrong. Yeah, that's gonna be one fifth, two fifths, three fifths, four fifths. One, two, three, four. Yeah, that's right. So each one of these percents is 20% along the way. So now we've got percent. We just need to do, when we choose an index into a new section, we want to do possible indices. Instead of using get rand, so count equals possible indices dot size. Okay, we ditch the rand and we go with clamp I percent times count clamped between 0 and count minus 1. We'll need to set a breakpoint there to make sure that's right. And then similarly, instead of using a random number to pick a random index here, we want to do. Oh, wait, before I get rid of the old code. That's the old code. Here's the new code. Index equals What's up, the jail nigga? What's up, man? Index equals clamp I percent times possible dot size clamp between 0 and possible dot size minus 1. Set a breakpoint there too. Some of these freaking wrong numbers. You back up your PC. Very important lesson. I agreed. So there, we're just not choosing gates willy-nilly. We're using smart algorithm based on the angle. All right, let's see this in action. We've got two breakpoints. We're going to make sure this is all working correctly because this is going to change everything. This needs to be good. All right, which breakpoint are we at? I is 0, N is 4, what's the percent? 0.2? Yes, that's what we wanted. 20%, perfect. Count is the number of possible indices. Oh, this is the very beginning. We haven't chosen any sections yet, so of course all of them are possible. Holy crap, Gel Mega, that's tough. Whoa, nice, Teak. That sounds pro. So possible indices, we're going to choose clamp I percent. Let's see what clamp I comes out with. We're clamping the value of, which is 20% of 30. Is exactly 6, right, duh. And we're clamping 6 between 0 and 29, which will return us which gate? We should probably get gate, if this is like 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it'll put a gate right there. That's actually a pretty good location for a gate, for the first gate. And then the next gate should come right about there, and then there. Let's see if it works. So index becomes 6. Oh, that's nice. All right, so what edge do we choose? We had all those possible edges. The sixth edge. Why isn't this a reference? I think that should be auto ref edge. Yeah, I don't see any reason why that's not an auto reference. Good call, man. I lost a Windows install the other day, too. Well, it wasn't the other day. It was like 6 months ago or something. I had to completely reinstall from a backup. For some reason, my Visual Studio just got all wonky. It wouldn't compile anymore. I reinstalled like a bajillion times. I reinstalled Visual Studio so many times. It never freaking worked. I had to actually roll back my entire OS just to get Visual Studio back to working. But I'm glad I did. Okay, so this index should be 6. Good. And the edge we choose. What edge did we choose? Edge number 6 is 8, 1, 17, 2. that right? Where's our edges? It's in this. No, it's not this. It's, where's, oh, possible. Edge number 6. This one's 14-1. Oh, no, it's this one. 8-1. I should probably floor F. No? Ceiling F? And besides, the percentage should be times count minus 1. And this one, same thing. We only have room to go up to possible dot size minus 1. And I guess the percent... This should be, should this be round F? Wow. Wow, dude. That's serious. Floor F. Floor F's definitely not right, because then you would be like, if you had 1.0, you'd be at the new value, but if you're at 0.9999, it would still be the value before. So that's not right. I guess it is round F or C left. If you're 0.9999. It's round F. I'm going to use round F. L round F. It's important, though. This makes a very subtle but more accurate difference here. Nice salad. Oh. All right, Ishni. See you guys. See you, Ishni. Later. Okay, let's run this again. Whoops. What did I do? Oh, this is supposed to be around the percent times count minus, yeah. Yeah. That's better. Oh, we probably don't need this doErase function anymore. Because these are using a distributed. Yeah, let's get rid of this. We don't need to erase elements anymore because we're using a smarter algorithm. Yeah, I hear you, man. It took me a whole week of trying to reinstall Visual Studio that one time, so I was finally like, reinstall. Well, I didn't have to reinstall. I just actually rewrote my entire disk with DD on my Mac because I'm on a triple boot here. So I'm like, I went into it on Mac and used, no, was it Linux? I don't remember. One of my OSs, I went back in, just DD'd the entire Windows partition back to a state which I had saved. which wasn't easy. But it was a lot less time consuming than trying to reinstall Visual Studio. All right, first index. We've got still a percent of 20%, right? Yes. Okay, this time we're choosing an angle. Instead of it being 6, is it different this time? Oh, it's still 6. I wonder what that actually was. As a float variable. Well, I L-rounded it, so I don't know. Okay, we're using L-round. I think that's the right way. And then we're also multiplying the percent by the count minus 1 and then clamping it between 0 and count minus 1. And same here, we're multiplying by a possible size minus 1 and then clamp between 0 and that. Yeah, Steam's pretty good about that stuff, huh? So we chose edge. Well, this is going to be the same edge. And then it gets a section and puts in a chosen section. Okay, now we're at index number 1, which gives percentage 40%. Let's see which one it chooses this time. Oh yeah, so this time possible indices is going to be a lot smaller. See, this time possible indices is only 3 because we already gated into, it was at 8.1. So 8.1, yeah, this gate. Or was it that gate? I don't know. One of these gates right about here. So it gated into this green section. So now it needs to either gate into the green section here or the brown section there. Possible sections is still 1, 2, or 3. Whoa, dang. Oh, there you go. Yeah, yes, yes. I'm happy you did too. Bitbucket's a good way to go, huh? They got free private repos. Chosen sections. We chose section 1. Why is possible sections? Oh, possible sections never changes. Okay, I get it now. It's just looking at the... It gets the current section into whatever edge that is, and then... If that's not one of the chosen sections... Okay, so possible... Oh! Possible indices this time is 20, so it's going to filter out all the ones that aren't... What did it filter out? Mostly from 5 to 15, which is these. Good. So we're choosing an angle. What's the percent into those? Forty percent of the way along into these indices. Hopefully that works. What do we get this time? So this time we got edge. Here, let's clear these up. And what's the first edge it shows? Chosen. A1, southeast. So right here. Right there is the first edge or the first gate it's going to choose, right there. All right, and then in the next one here, chosen pushback is going to be 6-5 northeast, going north, which is 6-5 northeast going north. Oh, that's a pretty good choice, actually. That is pretty distributed. So we've got this is 20% along the way, that's 40% along the way. Let's look at the next one. We're still going to be choosing a new section. This time, possible indices is going to be a lot smaller. It's only 16 as opposed to 20 last time. This time we pushed back. What do we get? X is 3-2 and northwest going west. 3-2, that's 1-2-3, 1-2, northwest going west. Oh, cool. That's actually a pretty good location as well. I like that. So it's got a gate right there. Let's look at, okay, so now we're going to get one more gate. And this time it's picking a random index. Or no, not, never pick a random index. Right on. Oh, yeah. Oh, so you at least got a week to recover, huh? That's good. All right, last edge. What do we get? 3-2 again? No, it chose the exact same thing. It chose an edge that's already been chosen. That can't be right. All right, so that totally got borked somewhere along the line. Probably because of the way possible indices works. Yeah. Honestly, this whole algorithm really isn't meant to work this way. I really need to use choose gates too. Okay, well, let's do it. I'm gonna rewrite this. There you go. That's a pretty good benefit. Sometimes you need that sort of spring cleaning, huh? So I'm going to put this one back the way it used to be. Choose gates too. Min dist. What's min dist? Oh, min dist is for when it sorts, it clears them out and stuff. We don't need possible sections. We don't need that at all. We don't need this. We just need to pick an index based on the percentage into the sorted possible gates. It's very simple. This algorithm just got like 10 times more simple. And we don't need to delete indices that are within a minimum distance because we've already got a nice sorted list. We don't need to even track the chosen sections. We just need an int I. Oh, wow. 512 SSD. Nice. Okay, so now we're gonna, when we choose the gates, we're gonna use choose gates to and let's watch this algorithm as it chooses different edges. That's luxurious. 512, right on. I think I'm on a 256 and it's tight. I got three OSs on this one SSD drive. Okay, first edge. So we're ditching that whole concept of possible indices because it didn't really work because we're already choosing a nice distribution. So percent is 20%, index is 6, the edge we got is 8.1 again. But the next edges are gonna get better. Now we're at index 1, n is 4 still, percent is 40%. This time we got edge 8.4. Already looking better. So it is this 8.4 southeast going east. This is 8.1, 2, 3, 4 southeast going east. So that's the second edge it chose. Nice. Yeah, that's rad. Wait, 8.5 northwest, what? Oh, because there's some other angles over here. There's some other stuff right there and there and there and there. Oh, damn. So it placed the next gate right there, which is a horrible choice. Is that right? That can't be right. There's so many other edges that it might choose. What? Chosen? Oh no, it's 8.1 and then 8.4. What's that other edge that it's showing me? 8.1, 8.4. No, it is 8.5. Damn. I'm gonna need to come up with something that'll make this algorithm better now, because it splits up. If there's a section over here, I guess I should make it so it never does these little tiny extra sections like that. Somehow this section got placed like that and just stomped over these, just split up that section. So it's like it should fix this orphan section. Maybe make that green. And then we wouldn't have this problem. Why, Murphy? So what are the last edge it chose? What is it? Wait, what? What? We lost it. All right, the last edge is 3, 2. Three, two, what? Going quadrant northwest, going west. 3, 2, northwest. Yeah, this one. So unfortunately, this is 8, 1, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5. Northwest, north. Oh, that's actually not too bad. It's right there. It's okay, so it kind of sucks that these two are so close together. It would be much better if it wasn't. And I guess the way to fix it is to fix that. So we don't have those anymore. But let's see how this world even turned out. Let's like let this actually run. I'm gonna turn that off and see what happens if I just let her go. All right, it worked. Did it have any? It did. Xanadu failed the first time, so we had one retry. So this is the second version of Xanadu. Yeah, I do. I use Cocos 2DX. And I use lots of libraries. I use fmod. I use some things I've wrote myself, like entity foo and valtree. Okay, so I'm going to turn on overworld. All right, so here's Xanadu with, is this the failed version? No, this is the one retry version. Here's Xanadu, the new Xanadu. I really want to fix this retry. Let's give this a look. All right, so where did it place its gates? Did all this again. Oh, nice. It placed the gate there. There's one here. There's one here. Wait, why is there one there and there's a gate right there? Oh, I guess. Wait, what? Why is it placing multiple gates? Like this and this and this and this. That one's okay. Oh, because the other one's using that algorithm. Oh. Okay, it would be much smarter. Thanks, man. Appreciate when it chooses gates, I'm gonna use the first algorithm. If we're gating the first section, so if is style light, is that a constants method now? I guess it. Oh, what? Oh, yeah. Now it's just a general function. All right. So I want if this style 0. So if this is the light section, then we're going to use choose gates 2. And otherwise, we use the good old random one from before, so it's not so rigid. And the other gates, as they're gating back into the other sections, will hopefully work a little better. Let's see if that also fixes the retry. It might. Okay, it didn't fix the retry. And it didn't fix the gates either. Ah. It did change a little. But not that much. What's up, voice of Grog? Right. Well, I made some progress on this algorithm, but I think it's time to take a break. 'Cause I what's happening is it's like it's creating these situations where it's placing the it's placing a gate right where it another gate already is. Let's go to this point and look at that. What does that actually look like? This is 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, hey. Yeah, I gotta take a break soon. I'm sick. I'm running out of energy. Wait. It does have a gate to the left, but not, there's no gate. What? This doesn't look right. There is a refill right there. Oh, this is placing a. No way. Is it placing a gate up there like that? Yeah, I did. Oh, it placed a gate right there. It's so weird. Why would it place a gate there? I don't get it. It's super crazy. It doesn't need a gate right here. Rocket Bunny! What's up, little buddy? How's it going, man? Sorry, I'm about to shut down the stream here in a second. Yeah. So I guess this is okay. It's actually placed a gate going to the west there, and then a north one right here. But it's still really weird to me that it placed a gate right here so close to another gate. In fact, this one is definitely weird. Let's go to that point. And then there's like this too. What is this? It doesn't need a gate right there. Something's messed up. Right on, man. How you been, Rocket? What's up? What's new? Okay, so those other gates were over this way. There's one, and then the next screen should have another one. Yeah, it does. Which I guess it's okay. But still, it's placed this gate in the middle of this whole section, which really don't understand why. Here's another one of its gates. Going into this section. This one's okay. It actually is a gate between sections. That's a nice gate between sections too, but it's like the last section. Oh, wait. Is the last section actually have style light? Oh, it does. The last section has style light. Oh. You've been under the weather too? Oh, yeah. It has. It's been raining a lot in California, and I've heard it's been snowing up there like crazy. You guys have been getting snow, right? Have you built any snowman or anything? So let's just do it for the first section, which has three styles. Hopefully that'll make this algorithm smarter. And let's go back and show the overworld. What? Nice. Right on. Oh, it's not this style. It is? Wow. You're Belgium? I know, right? Climate change. We got work ahead of us this century. We got to fix our planet. Still one retry. Still some weirdness with the gates. But less weirdness. There is less weirdness for sure. Oh. Good. Okay, that would definitely fix some of the problem. So, gates that lead out of this mountain section here are a little smarter because they use the old algorithm, which is random. I guess it's not really smarter. It's just that it works better because it's not putting two gates right next to each other because of they're all both exactly the same angle or whatever. So, gates into oh wait, the last section, I gotta remember how this works. The last section is, so the first one is from light, second one is from the sand, third one's from the dark, the last one is to the mountain, so it adds two more gates. Oh, no wonder. So I guess you do need to remove nearby. Right on. Where do you want to move in the US? I think I figured out this algorithm. Let's go and add back in to choose gates. This bit about removing sections that are too close to each other. Section, does that matter? Super Bowl. Is it today? Today the Super Bowl? Probably is. It's not today. When the hell is it? Alright, we need at least need this section here. So there, we're using this whole thing to delete any indice which is close to the others. And I do need to see that in action. 12. Okay, so we look for, let's just look at possible. So possible had 30 elements before, and we've chosen the edge at 8-1. So we're going to go delete anything that's close to that. Oh my god, this is going to change everything. I think. We got now possible has 26, so it removed a few elements, which means that the percent is going to change. It's going to be different next time. So let's see what index we get on the second time through because we removed some elements. Yeah, dude, I hope you do too. Uni's, I think, from what I've heard, I don't know if it's true or not, but I've heard that uni in Europe is better than in the States. At least you get a more quality education. And it's cheaper. It's so cheap to go to uni in the Europe. In America, you just have to foot the whole bill yourself. pay off your debts, and then go get a huge debt, and get yourself a house, get some more debt. Just stay in debt your whole life. That's the American way. So this time we chose index percent. What's the edge? Percent's 40, but the index is 10 this time. Edge will become 8.5. That's better. Wait, so it went from 8.1 to 8.5? That's pretty good. And then we delete again. So this next edge, we got percentage should now be 60. The index is 14. The edge is 6.5. 6.5? Oh, this is a different world. This is the old world. This one, 6.5. 6.5. Oh, so it'd be one there. This is looking better. Yeah, Germany, 300 for a semester. That's it. And it includes train tickets. Oh. Whoa. What, Rocket? That's so awesome. Gosh. Oh, man. I got to get going. We'll see what happens, though. Maybe this doesn't have any more retries. I'm just going to turn off that. Oh, I gotta take a break. Rest my sick body. Oh, this time I had two retries. Even worse. And we've got some crazy ass gates in this one. And once again, it generated a long ass divide. That sucks. Well, hell, I think this idea is sound, right? Of sorting by angle, but I need to work on it. Like, they put a gate there, there, there. These two are right next to each other. There's a gate. But see, it did this. It did another one of these things where it put no gate whatsoever all the way till there. So obviously this algorithm doesn't work yet. But I think it's on the right track. I got to fix some retries. I got to figure out why it's still doing this. This is good that Xanadu, after two retries, can generate a world like this because I can just go to that and then blah, 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 blah. So anyways... I gotta get going, you guys. Have a great night. Thanks a lot for watching. I appreciate you all. And I'll be back later. I'm probably gonna take a break and not stream tomorrow because I'm just still sick and stuff. I'm just getting recovered. So I'll probably be back Tuesday. So anyways, see you all. Have a great one.